Hello friends, welcome to Game It Up. My name is Dave, and people that follow this channel know that we tend to play Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, and we have been streaming it with you watching us at home. And if you haven't done so yet, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss the next time we do it. We'd love to have you on board. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe now has 96 tracks, which is quite a lot to put it simply. But which of this huge list is our favourite? Which one's our least favourite? And what of the 94 in between? And in what order? That is a lot of questions to be answered. And here is how we rank those tracks from our least favourite to our most favourite. We are in the UK, so some of the tracks' names may differ from what they're called in the US. No idea why that is, but oh well. And please, please, please remember that this is just our opinion and it will most likely be different from yours. I've done videos like this before and have had people see it as a personal attack on them if I put their favourites lower down, so just keep it in mind it's what we personally like. A few years ago I ranked the 48 initial tracks and I'll keep that list up, although some of those tracks are not in the same order now as they were back then, so my opinions can change over time it seems. They have been ordered based on which ones we would vote for over others when it gives you a choice of three when playing online. I on purposely left it a while before making this list because naturally there would be some recency bias over the new courses. Of course I'd vote for them when they're new and exciting. So now several months have passed and the hype has died down, it makes for a fair assessment of them. I actually used a website which is handy for making ranked lists. I'll link it in the description if you'd want to check it out yourselves. So, here are all 96 Mario Kart 8 Deluxe tracks, ranked from our least favourite to most favourite. Number 96, Bone Dry Dunes. I don't hate this track, I just don't really feel anything for it. It's just kind of bland and forgettable that I never feel like playing it. So, having complete indifference to a track is worse than hating one. I mean, at least the ones I hate get an emotion out of me. And with 96 tracks to choose from, one of them had to be left in the dust. 95, Rainbow Road. Now this one I do hate. It's actually moved down a few spaces since I last ranked them, as my hate for it has grown over the years. The idea of it being a space station is nice, but I just find myself falling off all of the time due to how sharp the turns are and how easy it is to misjudge a drift. My brother pointed out to me that this track will give you mushrooms more than any other. I don't know if that's true or not, but I just can't help but notice it. Number 94, 3DS Koopa City. Neo Bowser City is a better name, but this is what we have. It's a hard one for sure and has pretty cool location, but sadly this is another one with tight turns that I just don't find feel satisfying at all, even when I get the hang of it. At least I don't fall off as much on this one, but it's still unappealing. But hey, at least it's not raining. Oh, wait. Number 93, Tour Los Angeles Laps. Get ready to see all of the Tour City tracks in the bottom half of this list. They just don't really gel with me as much as the other courses. A lot of it comes from each lap being completely different, so it kind of makes them forgettable and confusing. The LA one is my least favourite. It starts off okay with a beach and at one point you glide over a baseball field, but other than that, the second lap is forgettable and the third lap, being an oil field, it just doesn't feel like a pleasant place to be. It looks very dull and brown and it doesn't really fit in with the really pleasant music playing. This track seems like hell, eh? Number 92, Bowser's Castle. I usually enjoy the Bowser's Castle tracks, but for some reason this one never clicked with me. I can race around it fine and there's a lot going on for sure, but I find this one to be pretty dull and I can't really explain why. I do like the giant Bowser statue punching the track though. Kamek probably brought that thing to life, but it still doesn't make the track enchanting enough. Number 91, Wii Grumble Volcano. This was my least favourite track on the Wii and it doesn't fare much better here. Parts of the track disappearing between laps is interesting, but it also makes it kind of annoying. It's better than the Wii version, but I could never get on board with this one. Grumble is a good word for this course as it's what I do when it gets chosen. Number 90, 3DS Toad Circuit. This was the introductory track for Mario Kart 7, which are designed to be simple to help you get used to the game's mechanics. It did that job fine in its debut, but here, as DLC, it feels kind of underwhelming. Not bad, but a bit dull. There's certainly much room for improvement. Number 89, Piranha Plant Cove. This was the final of the quote-unquote new tracks, exploring some ruins both in and out of the water. It's annoyingly one of those tracks that is different each lap, and I find it kind of dull to look at. Diving into the water feels pretty cool as you float down, but it's neither memorable or too exciting to play. This just doesn't whet my appetite. Number 88, Electrodrome. I know this one is popular, but I just don't enjoy this one. The aesthetic is very nice for sure, but my main problem is the fact that the path splits for the majority of the track, so you're just going along a straight line with only half the racers. It makes me feel a bit separated and removed from everyone else, making it feel a lot more mundane than the visuals deserve. I certainly don't rave about this one. Number 87, Ice Ice Outpost. This one has fallen down the ranks since last time. It's another track that splits, but I rate it a bit higher than Electrodrome, simply because you can jump between the halves, which make it a bit more interesting. It certainly wasn't the best of the initial game's DLC. It's not terrible, but given the choice, I'd leave this out in the cold. Number 86, Tour Berlin Byways. The run of city tracks begins. I can't say any of these are bad as I play them, but I can just never remember them afterwards. This one has a few things I like, such as driving through a train at one point and Womps falling down on you at the Berlin Wall. It's just another city track, but if you want to look at some German landmarks, you can do it by ways of this. Number 85, Tour Singapore Speedway. This is a visually nice track. It has several moments where you're launching through the air, which is pretty cool. The colours are what really make this pop out for me, but I do kind of get a bit disoriented by this one. I do find it to be a poor choice. Number 84, Tour Paris Promenade. This one stands out a bit more as it was the first city track in the DLC, and I have been to Paris, but other than that, it's another city track. You go backwards on the third lap and can meet others head on. That's pretty interesting, but otherwise, nothing too memorable. It's not a track I fall for. Number 83, Tour Rome Avanti. Yep, another city track. I like that you can go up the Colosseum and later drive through it where the chain chomps are chewing the road. It's basically another real-life city that's put into Mario Kart, where you can glide for coins guarded by fuzzies. Hey, when in Rome. Number 82, Tour Bangkok Rush. Sometimes I just look at the maps on these city tracks and think, what on earth is going on? This one is a pretty good one to race on, as it's not too confusing as you're following your way around. Then there's that building towards the end I really like, where you can do those tight turns into one drift if you're good, leading you to bouncing along the roofs on the stalls below. That's certainly quite a rush. Number 81, Tour London Loop. Another city! I only rate this one higher than the others so far because I'm from England, so that adds interest, but it is just another city track. I was in London a few months ago and I don't remember seeing giant chain chomps all over the place, even from the view of the London Eye, no sign of them at all. I don't think this game's very realistic. It's a bit loopy in fact. Number 80, Tour New York Minute. This one is a bit more interesting as you have moments driving through Central Park and seeing the skyscrapers is cool. But ultimately, this just makes me wish there was a new Donk City track, and I especially want to see this Donkey Kong musical. It's the best one, apparently. Definitely better than that one. Number 79, Sky High Sunday. The ice cream track, which is quote-unquote new. This one feels very floaty as you glide down one side and drive up the other, doing plenty of tricks. Not a bad one, but nothing too special, except for the ice cream helicopter. That's just amazing. It's basically one for a Sunday drive. Number 78, Sweet Sweet Canyon. The split track trilogy is complete, as is the Sweet Course Duology. I love the aesthetic here, it makes me think of Wreck-It Ralph. The split path thankfully doesn't last too long on this one, and there is a nice donut shortcut at the end I quite like. And those gingerbread toads? Perfection. If anyone on this track overtakes me, I see they get their just desserts. Number 77, 3DS Rosalina's Ice World. This one is kind of a disappointment overall. Rosalina gets a themed course and it's just a generic ice track. I wasn't keen on it on the 3DS and I'm not too keen on it here. It's really a shame there is no real Mario Galaxy themed track, as the anti-gravity was surely made for this. But saying that, it's still a decent track to play on, but it doesn't kick too much ice. Number 76, GCN Dry Dry Desert. This was my least favourite in Double Dash, and while it's still pretty low here, I have grown to enjoy it more over the last few years. The desert setting isn't the most interesting, unless there's a train of course, we'll get to that later. This has some nice drifting opportunities and corners that are tempting to skip with mushrooms, and I do like that this version has a water section, even if it does contradict the name. Number 75, Tour Madrid Drive. Another city track. This I remember more fondly as there are some memorable moments, such as the sleeping wiggler who wakes up in the second lap, driving through the art gallery where the piranha plant comes out of a painting, and, of course, the bit where you drive through the football pitch and there are some Goombas playing football in those shoes. Madrid satisfy me enough. Number 74, Tour Vancouver Velocity. You know, I'm actually beginning to enjoy some of these city tracks. This snowy track has you driving over some bridges, through a park, and you end up going for a skating rink. Twice. This one is more memorable for me. Question for Sonic fans, do we pronounce this Velocity or Velo-City? Number 73, Tour Amsterdam Drift. I kind of enjoyed this city track. I think it gave a good first impression when you glide over a train and through some windmills. It reminded me of a track in Diddy Kong Racing, which is my favourite racing game of all time, so I'm immediately in a good mood. You spend quite a bit of time in the canal water, which is pretty unhygienic, I'm sure, but a lovely ride through the tulips makes everything better. Yeah, not bad this one, if you get my drift. Number 72, Wild Woods. This is a pretty fun one to race on, although it is a bit disorienting as you're driving up and down the trees without it looking like you are. That's the fun of anti-gravity, I suppose. But overall, this does look like a fun place to be, and at least it's not as confusing to navigate as a certain other woods from a Nintendo game. Number 71, Mario Kart Stadium. Sometimes the opening track can be a bit basic and boring, such as Toad Circuit, but this is probably the best opening track there is. The wide roads let you get used to the drifting, the anti-gravity isn't overbearing, and you even get a glider at the end. A fun opener for sure. Number 70, GBA Mario Circuit. Kinda similar to the previous entry, but I prefer it ever so slightly. They've taken a GBA track and revamped it to meet the modern gameplay really well. I like the raised up bit for anti-gravity, which you can see rise up in the intro, like the characters have returned here and are making the adjustments themselves. Mario Kart has some deep lore, I'm telling ya. Number 69, Mario Circuit. The flagship track gets the funny number. These three Mario tracks were grouped together last time and it's the same story here, but the two new ones will come later. This is a figure eight track layout where you drive on the top and bottom sides of, with the track twisting to change which side you're on. A clever idea for sure, and it doesn't feel too gimmicky. I'd hate to think what design they'd go for when Mario Kart 69 finally comes round though. Number 68, GCN Sherbet Land. This is all over the place for me. I ranked it low in Double Dash, I ranked it higher than this when I did my initial Mario Kart 8 video, and now it's back down again. I do like this track still, and it's an improvement over Double Dash with the inclusion of the underwater sections. The skating shy guys are awesome too. Ask me again tomorrow, and I'll probably put it in at number 1. Or maybe number 96. Who knows? Number 67, GBA Sky Garden. This is kinda basic, but I enjoy it all the same. The sky theme was done better in another track I'll mention later, but this isn't a bad one. There's some bouncy leaves you can boost across and a small shortcut towards the end I usually try even if I don't have the necessary mushroom. It's gotta be done. It may be one of the highest geographically, but it's not one of the highest on the list. Number 66, DS Shroom Ridge. This is one I wasn't looking forward to returning, as it didn't feel like an interesting track. It's one of those car avoiding tracks, and although there is a big shortcut you can do towards the end which is pretty fun, but what made me appreciate it a lot more is that this is one of those tracks that you can get that triple drift boost on several corners. That'll be the reason they brought this one back, I assume. Number 65, Superbell Subway. Driving along a subway is pretty unique. It has trains to avoid that aren't too bad to dodge. There are also places to find on the sides to trick boost off, and there are some signs referencing other tracks, which is nice to see. Remember before this track was officially unveiled and people saw the word Metro attached to it and assumed it was short for Metroid? I like to think Samus is driving one of the trains. Number 64, Wii Daisy Circuit. I was surprised this one was brought back, but I'm not unhappy about it. It's a nice simple track with the secret stairs to boost up, some nice wide turns to drift along. The statue of Luigi and Daisy is always the most memorable thing about it. Pretty fun, if not too memorable. It's not the most crazy Daisy track in this game. Number 63, Tour Sydney Sprint. The final slew of cities begins. Sydney Sprint always stood out for me as some of my earlier memories came from when we went to Sydney. I like the look and feel of this one, and driving through the Opera House at the end is a nice touch. Pretty good city track, but it has to place down under a few others. Number 62, Tour Athens Dash. This one feels very different to the other city tracks, as you spend your time driving around ruins and monuments that I'm not going to pretend I know the names of, but I find it enjoyable to race around them. With plenty of opportunities to do tricks and an epic tune playing, there are worse ways to spend your time with this game. Anyways, let's dash to the last city now. Number 61, Tour Tokyo Blur. I know, a lot of people rate this as the worst city track, so why have I put it as the best? A couple of reasons. Firstly, we went to Tokyo last year, so that added interest in seeing the landmarks we recognise, such as the Tokyo Skytree that we went up. But also because it's the shortest of the city tracks, so if I was forced to pick a city track, it's bound to be the one that's over quickly. Is that too mean? But it's nice for us to remember this track and not to have it be a blur. Number 60, GBA Boo Lake. This is quite an exciting track. You take the idea of driving along a haunted pier and then you alter it to go under the water, and then you can tilt the track to make anti-gravity, and there's lots of tricks you can pull off. I do find this one quite tricky, but when on the rare occasions I get it right, it's a ghoulishly fun time. Number 59, SNES Donut Plains 3. This feels like a nice recreation of the Super Nintendo track, with Monty Moles and Broken Bridges keeping things interesting. The layout works well for drifting and it is a nice competitive track. Donut passed this one up. Number 58, 3DS Alpine Pass. This was another track I thought was a dull pick for the DLC, but having played it again, I forgot how much I enjoyed it. The two highlights being the long gliding section and the steep uphill ride at the end with boulders to dodge, now in anti-gravity. I wouldn't Alpine Pass this one up. Yeah, I won't make that kind of joke again. Number 57, SNES Mario Circuit 3. I see a lot of people say this one is awful based purely on the fact that it's flat. I myself kind of enjoy the fact that it's flat. I'd agree with people if this was like the DS or Wii where all of the SNES tracks were flat, but the fact that this is the only one means that it being flat is a gimmick in itself, and I really enjoy the nostalgic feeling of this one as well as the drifting. It's still in the bottom half of the list, but I seem to be one of the few that enjoys it, even if it isn't too SNES-sational. Number 56, Wii Moonview Highway. Another one I wasn't keen on seeing come back, and another one I found a lot more enjoyable than I remember. It's one of them car avoiding tracks that's not too annoying. I enjoy trying to go up the side near the start, and it's nice to see the bomb car back too. This track certainly is a blast, unless I can avoid those bomb cars. Number 55, DS Cheap Cheap Beach. A gentle relaxing drive along a peaceful beach, well, as much as it can be in Mario Kart. The fact that you drive in the water now makes this a bit more enjoyable than the DS original. It's a simple enough track and fun to race on. Any pun I make on this track may feel a bit cheap. Number 54, DS Mario Circuit. If you had told me the lineup ahead of time, I would never have thought this would rank as my favourite of the Mario Circuit, but I really do enjoy it. It has the typical raceway design with some nice drifting opportunities, hazards here and there, but what I really like is the added wood section, and on the third lap, there is a wiggler that appears and scared the hell out of me the first time I played this. You can even see it sleeping in earlier laps. Out of all the Mario circuits in this game, I find DS to be the best. Number 53, Wii Wario's Goldmine. A real rollercoaster ride this one is. It's a real adrenaline rush of a track that I like and Sophie hates. It's better than the Wii version because the minecarts actually give you boosts this time rather than knocking you over. This is pure gold. Number 52, GBA Riverside Park. A short and simple one, but I really do like the setting. The highlight being the finale as you go shooting out of a waterfall. Other than that, there isn't a whole lot to talk about, but it is enjoyable to race on. It's especially nice to see those piranha plants going for a stroll, or maybe they're uprooting. Number 51, Twisted Mansion. It's sad Luigi's Mansion didn't come back, but this one will do nicely. You have those wiggly floors I like to trick off, statues that try to squash you, and Boo seems to have a flooding problem. Maybe that's why he called a plumber in. Number 50, SNES Bowser's Castle 3. But one person that has the opposite problem is Bowser, as his castle is surrounded by lava. Maybe Boo should donate some water to him. They've taken a Super Nintendo track and really run wild with it. There's plenty of obstacles to dodge, anti-gravity sections, and some 180 degree turns to get some nice drifting done. I was so happy this came in the last wave. This game finally has a good Bowser's Castle track. It's hot stuff. Number 49, Thwomp Ruins. Well, if you stick some thwomps here, of course you're going to end up with ruins. This track contains some tighter turns inside an enclosed area, a super duper not so secret route over the water that eventually opens up, and at times those thwomps can drive you up the wall. Number 48, GBA Sunset Wilds. This track is terrible because the sun doesn't go down. People have to find minor things to complain about these days, but instead of complaining, I'm just going to enjoy a fun track with some awesome music. And it's nice to see Sophie get excited when the Shy Guys appear. Too much sunset, not enough wilds it seems, but I still like it. Number 47, GBA Snowland. Seeing that we're in the top half of the list, let's throw in some Penguins. Another GBA reimagining that gives you a short but exciting track to race on, with the frozen lake to drift around, a few little shortcuts with the help of mushrooms, and the aforementioned penguins sliding in your way, all while the Parson Browns cheer you on. This is Snow Joke. Number 46, DS Tick-Tock Clock. It's a Switch port of a Wii U game that's remade a DS track from a level of an N64 game. Still with me? This is a more abstract track that takes a theme and runs with it. With pendulums swinging, clock hands turning, and gears and cogs aplenty, a fantastic idea that creates plenty of obstacles to dodge and environments to trick off. This is definitely a good time. Number 45, DS Wario Stadium. Not the Wario Stadium I would want back, but it's still a pretty damn good one. It has the typical ramps and jumps you'd expect as you drive through the muddy terrain and you dodge fire. This one can get quite competitive, so you better show off your smooth moves. Number 44, Cloud Top Cruise. I said this with the Rosalina course, but this one makes me wish there was a Mario Galaxy themed track, seeing that it has music from that game here. The actual track itself though, pretty damn good. Travelling along the clouds, airships and beanstalks, ending with lightning attacking the stage. It's an epic adventure in the skies, it's simply divine. Number 43, Wii Rainbow Road. So I'll make a confession, I know everyone rates this a lot higher than I am right here. I do like this track, but when it got revealed to be returning, I wasn't as excited as everyone else. I honestly couldn't remember this one outside of those two large circles you can boost over near the beginning. But playing it again, wow, it is an epic one, and I do really enjoy it. The fact that I've placed it around the halfway mark on this list, don't see that as an insult to the track, but more see it as a testament to how much I enjoy the 42 other entries on this list. Number 42, Wii Mushroom Gorge. Now here's a Wii one I was excited to see back. Bouncing on mushrooms is always satisfying as you gain the boosts with correct timing, the highlight being the cave where you have the choice over which mushrooms to bounce on, and the blue one lets you glide for it before hitting the final tight turn. Whoever designed this one is surely a fun guy. Number 41, 3DS Melody Motorway. Like with Tick-Tock Clock, they took a more abstract idea and ran with it. This time the theme is music, and there are plenty of instruments scattered around, drifting over pianos and xylophones to make the sounds as you do so. You can also bounce on drums and dodge the musical notes, and there's dancing piranhas, which can be a lot of fun, and this track is quite rewarding when you have the right tempo remote. Number 40, GBA Cheeseland. This is another GBA recreation that completely transformed the track. This has some really fun shortcuts to pull off with the aid of mushrooms. The reason this only just scrapes the top 40 and isn't any higher is because Sophie is lactose intolerant, so Nintendo weren't being very inclusive when they brought this one back. I think any pun I make on this one will be too cheesy. Number 39, GBA Ribbon Road. This one takes place in a child's bedroom, a fantastic idea for this remake. With lots of bumpy bits of carpet to trick on, building blocks to shortcut off, and some tight and twisty track designs, this is a winner for sure, and those yarn Yoshis give this track a good feel. Number 38, Dragon Driftway. I don't think this is talked about as much as some of the other tracks, but my goodness do we love this one. You drive through the mouth of a dragon, drive along its body, and then end by leaping off its tail to go again. It really takes advantage of the anti-gravity with a unique aesthetic that really works. It's just a really clever idea done right. I won't let this entry drag on too much though. Number 37, 3DS Piranha Pipeway. Based on the second level of Super Mario Bros., where you start by going down the pipe and end by gliding to the castle. I love it when a track has a theme like this, and while underground it is a rush to avoid piranha plants and use water and jumps to your advantage. Too bad there's no secret warp zone, but this track is simply one to enjoy. Number 36, 3DS DK Jungle. The track based on Donkey Kong Country returns. It returns alright, and we are delighted to see it. Making your way through the dense jungle, up some ramps and through a temple, and then gliding your way to victory, with tikis to dodge along the way too. This is a track to go bananas for. Number 35, N64 Toad's Turnpike. A very memorable track from Mario Kart 64. This version stands out less, but it's more enjoyable to race on. The vehicles are easier to avoid, you can drive up some of them, and there's added anti-gravity along the sidewalls. The vehicles don't come towards you in mirror mode, sadly, and the lay-bys now have coins instead of item boxes, which means we can't call the CPUs cheats this time. In the N64 version, they never went into those lay-bys, yet they always had items. I'm not still bitter about it 25 years later. Honest. Number 34, Dolphin Shoals. We call this one the eel from World 3. Why? Because you drive along the eel from World 3 of Super Mario 64. Why else? Funny how we noticed that more than the dolphins the track is named after, but we do enjoy the underwater shenanigans, as well as using the bubbles coming out of the pipes to drift upwards over long gaps. This is an eerily good time. Number 33, Mute City. Nintendo acknowledging F-Zero at last. This is one of those tracks that's actually fun in 200cc, as F-Zero is tailor-made for speed. This obviously doesn't match how fast F-Zero goes, but it does keep the speed thing going with all the boost pads and anti-gravity. Having boost refills give you coins is a really nice touch too, and the music is so good that, despite the title, you really don't want this on mute. Number 32, Shy Guy Falls. We call this one Singing Shy Guys. Because of the Singing Shy Guys, of course. This is a great idea for the anti-gravity gimmick. Driving up and down a waterfall, what else could you want? Shy Guys That Sing? Did I mention that already? I did? Waterfall I am. Number 31, Wii Moo Moo Meadows. The N64 bias to me would love to see Moo Moo Farm back, but I can't deny that this is a superior track, as it feels more like a farmland than just a dirt track. The cows get in your way, as well as Monty Mole, and you can trick off the molehills. Those cows are called Moo Moos, by the way. Number 30, SNES Rainbow Road. An absolute classic, sort of flat as well, but this is a thrilling ride with the lack of barriers making it more dangerous. The thwomps creating shockwaves to boost off is a nice touch as well. It's not our favourite Rainbow Road, but it's certainly a super one. Number 29, Water Park. I don't know how many other people would place this in the top third, but we do, obviously. I love the water theme park setting, where you have the merry-go-round and the Ferris wheel at the end. I'll be honest, my favourite thing about this track is that wide left turn, as I enjoy building up the triple speed boost here. If that wasn't there, I don't know how high this would rank. Oh, there's a Waluigi seabed. I'd love to go there. Pair that with the Ferris wheel having Wario's logo. This was a Wario track all along. He really is the master of disguise. Number 28, N64 Rainbow Road. This was our least favourite track in the N64 one, but we love it here. Even though it technically ranks lower than the number 16 slot from our Mario Kart 64 video, this is how you remake a bad track, by making it good. They took a long and boring track and made it one lap so it doesn't take too long, and even made it more exciting, with bouncing chain chomps creating trick opportunities and it just feels faster. Seriously, I would still love this if it was 3 laps. Sophie wanted this at number 1 just for the train alone, but I decided to station it here. Number 27, Toad Harbour. This is a relatively simple track, with a few split paths that don't detriment the course like some previous ones did for me. I enjoy bouncing on the roofs of the market stalls towards the beginning, driving on the walls later on, and also finding that super secret alleyway that I always drive down, even though I don't know if it's quicker to do so. I don't harbour a grudge against this track at all. Number 26, N64 Choco Mountain. This was a memorable track in the N64 game, and it feels brand new here. It's a shame they altered it so you can't fall back onto a previous part of the track, but it makes it less frustrating. The added caves and glider sections make it feel really fresh, and removing that wall at the start makes it feel less closed in and more like it's part of a bigger world. Maybe my nostalgia plays a big role in placing this high up, but I can't resist that music. I'm pretty sure that's not chocolate either. Number 25, Wii Maple Treeway. The autumn setting gives this a pretty unique look as you race among the treetops, with giant wigglers and dead leaves aplenty. There's something about racing along the giant tree branches that just feels satisfying, allowing for a more natural feeling track layout, given how tree branches can twist and turn, and they really nailed it here. It really is a tremendous course. Number 24, Big Blue. Another F-Zero? Nintendo, you're spoiling us. This time a single linear track with three sections, which really allows them to make longer stretches to build up your speed. It's more hazardous and keeps you on your toes a lot more. But this is also my favourite F-Zero music. I certainly don't feel blue when this track is chosen. Number 23, Merry Mountain. It certainly is that. A fantastic aesthetic, a proper trek up and down a mountain without the use of a cannon. A train? Who doesn't love them? I do enjoy a Christmas themed stage in games when they come around. Not often though. About once a year, I suppose. Number 22, DS Peach Gardens. A nice relaxing drive around gardens sounds nice. Driving through the flowers, probably ruining them, and seeing the hedges and some very impressive topiary of Mario characters. And Peach for some reason has pet chain chomps she lets bounce around. This one is notable for the third lap having you do it backwards. It's always interesting to see the tracks from the opposite point of view. We're really living on the hedge here. Number 21, Wii Coconut Mall. I always enjoy a trip to the mall, but I wish we could shoot through it in go-karts. I love the ever-changing escalators, I mean that should happen in real life. The Shy Guys doing donuts out the back is funny, and you always have to cut through that one shop to save a second or two. Iconic music and an overall iconic track. I do go coconuts for this one. Number 20, GCN Daisy Cruiser. Like with them all, this one takes another real-world location, a cruise ship, and gives you everything you'd need for a track in that setting. A swimming pool you can drive through, a dining room where tables fly back and forth, and an optional path to the flooded area where you can blast out of a pipe to reach the deck. A great idea, really fun to race through, just don't keep it in cruise control. Number 19, 3DS Rainbow Road. The best Rainbow Road? It is a popular one, and it's my favourite in this game as it feels like a real adventure. It really is amazing that this game has 5 Rainbow Roads and they all look unique and stand out as their own. This one has you bouncing around planets and in moon craters, all done as one single lap. Pretty sure that's Olimar's ship as well. Of the Rainbow Roads, 3DS is 3D best. Yeah, that one worked better earlier, didn't it? Number 18, Wii DK Snowboard Cross. Another mountain track, this time with a snowboarding theme. Blast out of a cannon to the top of the mountain and race your way down. Lots of twisty turns and stunt opportunities to keep the momentum going, and a half pipe at the end to really show off your skills. I give this track a 1080 out of 10. Number 17, Wii Cooper Cape. This was one of my favourite Wii tracks back in the day, and it's my favourite Wii track in this game, it seems. After making your ascent at the start, you do a sharp left and have a fun area with flowing water that you want to stay in to go that little bit faster, and the pipe section is fun too. Lots of fun capers to be had here for sure. Number 16, N64 Calamari Desert. This is that one with the train. I think we already mentioned how much we love those. Of course my N64 bias plays a part here, but this wasn't the most exciting track to bring back, admittedly, until I got to the second lap, and it had me racing along the train track and through the tunnel. I always loved exploring in there as a kid, so it's great that it's part of the track now. I certainly do like to choose this course. Number 15, N64 Yoshi Valley. A history making course here. It's a shame this one tells you your position, as the mystery made it fun in the N64 version, but that doesn't take away from the fantastic design of this course. Right, left, right is the fastest route, isn't it? Falling off no longer takes 10 years for you to get picked up again, and also watch out for that giant Yoshi egg at the end, or there'll be shell to pay. Number 14, Yoshi's Island. Another Yoshi track, the quote-unquote new one, based on Yoshi's Island game. Nintendo really did go all out with this one, including many references to the series scattered all around. There's all sorts of terrain as well, including underwater and into the skies, where there's even a flying cloud that unlocks an extra part of the track if you hit it. I'm not good at it, but I always try to get it. A great track, great tribute, and not a crying baby Mario in sight. Unless I throw a red shell in his stupid face. Number 13, GCN Yoshi Circuit. Rounding off our unintentional Yoshi trilogy, seriously, this was just a coincidence, we have the GameCube Classic. A circuit track shaped like Yoshi. Yoshi's body sure has a lot of curves, which lends itself to some fantastic drifting. If you really want to get good, then this is a great track to practice, and it's so satisfying to be able to complete a whole lap with perfect drifts all the way. It can be quite taxing, but that's the only taxing thing Yoshi doesn't avoid. Number 12, Ninja Hideaway. A ninja themed track, and who doesn't love ninjas? This is another track that has a split path, which I have complained about before, but for some reason I love this one. I think it's because taking the top level requires some challenge, so it feels rewarding to make it up there for the whole lap. But the setting really does escalate this track high in my mind. Not quite top 10, but it sneaked its way into 12. Number 11, Squeaky Clean Sprint. The best of the quote-unquote new courses from the DLC. Giant houses are fun. We already have the kids' bedroom, so now we have the bathroom. Kitchen next. I love that you go down a plug hole and see a lost engagement ring under there. Mario's used to going down massive drains though. You can also glide over a toilet that squirts water out, and there's some fun extras to see scattered around the track. Good clean fun. Number 10, Hyrule Circuit. Here we go, top 10, and we're starting in style. A Zelda themed track where you drive around the castle grounds and through the castle itself, where the Master Sword is displayed. This game isn't canon then. They've made some cosmetic changes, Prada plants are Deku Babas, swoops are keys and coins are rupees. It doesn't change the gameplay, but it does do a lot to immerse you in this world. There's also a puzzle where if you hit three switches, it makes a shortcut to jump through the Master Sword. A nice little touch to make it more Zelda-like. This course is pretty legendary. Number 9, Excitebike Arena. This is a simple track, but an interesting one at the same time. Just two long straight roads with a 180 degree turn at each end. What keeps this interesting is the constant tricks you'll be doing with plenty of ramps and speed boosts along the way. And what really makes me want to keep coming back to it is the fact that it's different every time you play. So if you get that lucky combination of ramps that allows you to keep tricking non-stop, then it's an absolute rush and very satisfying to pull off. Excite surely is the word here. Number 8, Sunshine Airport. Airports aren't the most interesting of places, but it makes for an interesting track, even though you're barely inside the airport itself. You spend most of the time on the runways where you can drive through a plane before launching up to a floating piece of track, before gliding down again as you see a plane take off over your head, which is an epic shot. And tricking off the conveyor belt has to be done too, it helps you get to terminal velocity. Number 7, DS Waluigi Pinball. Of course the two Waluigi tracks are in the top 10, and this is one of them. Inside a giant pinball table where you launch yourself up and drive down it, avoiding the giant pinballs and obstacles along the way. A great design for a great idea, some of the best music in Mario Kart history, and this track really does score highly. Number 6, GCN DK Mountain. A GameCube classic. Blast out of the cannon to the top of the mountain and race your way down. Didn't I already say that in DK Snowboard Cross? Well, this one did it first. I love the angry volcano and how twisty the track is on your way down. That rickety bridge is scary to drive over at the end, but it just adds to the excitement. It's not a very long track, but I have a lot of fond memories of it and I love that it's here. I always feel inclined to pick this one. Number 5, N64 Royal Raceway. What a great remake of an N64 track. Yeah, they sadly removed the ability to visit the castle, but they did everything else right. The bends are tight and great to drift around without being too frequent or overbearing, even though there are some challenging ones. The ramp is now a glider section with a hot air balloon. It's one that, with practice, became one of my absolute favourites in this game. This track was a crowning achievement. Number 4, Animal Crossing. The best of the other franchise tracks. They not only made a fantastic track themed around Animal Crossing, but they created four different versions of it reflecting the seasons. The layout is the same every time, but there are some slight differences in how they play. It's nice to spot all the cameos from Animal Crossing villagers at the side, and also avoiding Rossetti, being as annoying as ever. Including tracks based on other Nintendo franchises really does open up new horizons for the Mario Kart series. Number 3, GCN Waluigi Stadium. Waluigi's the wiener! Well, he's third, and what a track this is. It's like Wario Stadium, but more fun I find. That mud really does look good in this version. Well, as good as mud can look. I love the big jumps near the start, the big mud pool to boost over, the obviously fake piranha plants, and the added anti-gravity sections that take some practice to reach consistently. It's a shame Waluigi didn't get a brand new track in this game. I mean, as this list shows, I really like his existing ones. They can be quite wacky. Number 2, Mount Wario. Is that a course or a command? Another mountain track, this time with a snowboarding theme. That's the last time I'll copy something from DK Snowboard Cross. You start in a plane and it's a single race down to the bottom of the mountain, divided into three sections, which all feel unique. The start feels more treacherous before you go through a dam, then past some trees before heading through a slalom track. Really good fun this one. One of the absolute best tracks in Mario Kart history. It's varied, chaotic, challenging, and keeps you engaged the whole way through. There's no way I would prefer an incredibly simple and basic track design to this, surely. And number 1, GCN Baby Park. I am not even sorry. I have loved this track since it was first revealed for Double Dash, and I love it to this day. Just a simple, small circuit with two 180 degree turns that you race 7 laps around. It's less manic than the original with the lack of giant items and a barrier in the middle, but the anti-gravity does add to it at the same time. Whenever we are done playing, we always say, this will be the last race we do unless Baby Park shows up. We cannot say no to it. It may have its haters, but I certainly am not one of them. The simplest ideas are sometimes the best.